குருபியோ நமக. டுடே ஐ எம் கோயிங் டு டீச் ஃபோர்த் ஸ்டாண்டர்ட் டாபிக் மெஷர்மெண்ட்ஸ். ஓகே, வி வுட் ஹவ் ஹர்ட் த வேர்ட் மெஷர் இன் அர் டே டு டே லைஃப் வெரி ஆஃபன். நவ் ஐ ஹாவ் அ ஃபியூ ஆப்ஜெக்ட்ஸ், ப்ளீஸ் கேன் யூ ஐடென்டிஃபை வாட் ஆர் தே? நவ் எஸ், கேன் யூ டெல் மீ வாட் இஸ் திஸ்? திஸ் இஸ் த மெஷரிங் டேப். திஸ் is a ruler which you use it in your day to day life, where you use it to draw lines. And then what is this? It is a measuring jar which helps you to measure liquids. And this is a weighing machine which helps you to find the weight of solid objects. So when I hang an object in this, it will tell you what is the weight of the object. Yes, in measurements we have three basic components. They are length, mass and capacity. Length, first of all we shall see what is length. Length is the distance between two points. That is, example, the length of this chalk piece is the length distance between the top and the bottom of the chalk piece. Here length, or you can express length in different ways, like the length of your room or the distance between two places is also measured using length. Here we use units to express the length. Example, centimeters, millimeters and meters, kilometers. When we measure small distance, example the length of this chalk piece or the length of your pencil or the length of your textbook, all that we measure using centimeters. And in case you're going to measure the breadth or the diameter of this chalk piece, we use millimeters, which is a very small distance. But when you're going to measure the length of the room, we use meters, which is a larger unit, because it's very convenient to use meters instead of centimeters. The same way, when you're measuring the distance between two places, we use kilometers. Okay, now how will you convert from one unit to another, or express one unit in terms of another? How to express one unit in terms of another? First one, we shall see about centimeter to meter. Centimeter to meter. 1 centimeter is equal, 1 meter is equals to 100 centimeters. 1 meter is equals to 100 centimeters. Now, if I have 500 centimeter, how can I express 500 centimeters in meters? That is, 1 meter is equals to, or you can say it as 100 centimeter is equals to 1 meter. So 500 centimeters is equals to 5 meters, because there are 5 hundreds in 500. Okay, let's see another example. It is 350 centimeter. How will I write 350 centimeter in meters? 1 meter is equals to 100 centimeter. Okay. Now in this we have 350. That is 300 plus 50. This 300 can be written as 3 meters, and this 50 you have to write it as 50 centimeters. So 350 centimeters can be written as 3 meters and 50 centimeters. Now if I'm going to convert from meter to centimeter, meter to meter to centimeter, same, 1 meter is equals to 100 centimeter. If I have six meters, 1 meter is 100 centimeter, 6 meter will be 6 into 100, that is 600 centimeters. Okay, if I have 7 meters, 35 centimeters, how will I convert? I'll convert the 7 meters into centimeters and then add the 35 centimeters. That is 7 meter is equals to 700 centimeter and 7 meter 35 centimeter is equals to 700 plus 35, that is 735 centimeter. Okay, one more example in the same thing. If I have 8 meter 5 centimeter, so in this 8 meter is equals to 800 centimeter and add the 5 centimeter. So I will have 8 meter 5 centimeter is equals to 805 centimeter. Okay. This is about length. Now we shall see what is mass. Mass is the weight of objects, solid objects. We measure solid objects using the units kg or grams. We usually use kg and grams. Now in standard it is 1 kg is equals to 1000 grams. So when we go to the market, we buy vegetables either in kgs, or if you're going to buy some gold or any ornaments, we buy in grams, we don't buy in kgs. So here we can see an example where how we can divide this grams to get 1 kg. Here 2 500 grams makes 1 kg. That is 500 plus 500 is 1000 and it is equals to 1 kg. Same way 4 250 grams is equals to 1 kg. Then 5 200 grams is equals to 1 kg and 1000 grams is equals to 1 kg. Now we shall see a few examples where we can convert from kg to grams and from grams to kg. Before that, I would like to say that what do you mean by half a kg? What is half a kg? Half a kg means half of 1000, that is 500 grams. And 1 by 4 kg, what is 1 fourth of a kg? 1 fourth of a kg is equals to 250 grams. And what is 3 by 4 of a kg? 3 fourth of a kg is 750 grams. Okay, now we shall see a few examples. That is kg to grams. First, example, 3 kg. What is 3 kg? You know that 1 kg is equals to 1000 grams. So 3 kg is equals to 3 into 1000, that is 3000 grams. 1 kg is 1000 grams, 3 kg is 3000 grams. Okay, tell me what is 4 1 by 4 kg. Now, I shall take it as 4 kg plus 1 by 4 kg. So, what is 4 kg? 4 into 1000. 4 into 1000 is 4000 grams plus, and 1 by 4 kg is 250 grams. So, you have 4250 grams. 1 by 4 kg is 4250 grams. Now, we shall see conversion from grams to kg. Grams to kg. Same, 1000 grams is equal to 1 kg. Okay. Example, 5000 grams. So, according to the formula, 1000 grams is equal to 1 kg. So, 5 can be written as 5 into 1000, that is 5 kg. Okay, what is 3750 grams? 3750 grams. I can write it as 3000 grams plus 750 grams. I know that 1000 grams is 1 kg. So 3000 grams is 3 kg plus 750 grams is 3 by 4 kg. So the total is 3 by 4 kg. So 3750 grams is 3 by 4 kg. Next. Coming to capacity. Like solids, we are unable to measure the liquids with the same instruments. Example, with the weighing machine, we cannot weigh the liquids. So we use measuring jars and other instruments to measure liquids. Now, and we measure them as liters and milliliters. We use units liter and milliliter. So this can be expressed as L and this is ml. Okay, for smaller quantities, example, when you are drinking a syrup, we use the smaller unit, that is ml. We usually take 5 ml of medicine. But when you are buying milk or when you are buying a can of water, we use liters. Now here also, 1000 ml is equal to 1 liter. 1000 ml is equal to 1 liter. Same way, like your mass or kg, we have 500 ml. That is, 2 500 ml is equal to 1 liter and 4 250 ml is equal to 1 liter, 5 200 ml is equal to 1 liter and 1000 ml is equal to 1 liter. If I say I have 4 bottles, I have 4 bottles of 200 ml. So what should be added to this to make 1 liter? I have 4 200 ml of water. What should be added to that to make 1 liter of water? That is, 4 200 ml is 800 ml. So I should add 200 ml to make 1000 ml, which is equal to 1 liter. Okay, now converting from milliliter to liter and from liter to milliliter. Liter to milliliter. As I said, 1 liter is equal to 1000 ml. 1 liter is equal to 1000 ml. If I have example 6 liters, so 6 into 1000, that is 6000 ml. Or if I have 3 liters and half, that is 3.5 liters. If I have 3.5 liters, how can I change it to ml? 3 liters, I can write it as 3 liters plus half liter. So that is 3000 ml plus 500 ml. That is equal to 3500 ml. Now we shall change from milliliter to liters. When you are converting from milliliter to liter, I'll write it as 1000 ml is equal to 1 liter. Okay, now if example I'm having 500, okay, 500 ml. So you know that 1000 ml is 1 liter, 500 is half of it, so we write it as half a liter. Or if I have 4750 ml, I can split it as 4000 plus 750 ml. This is ml. So this is 4 liter and this is 3 by 4 liter. That is 4 3 by 4 liters. This is the way we convert from milliliter to liters. Okay. In our day-to-day life, we use all these measurements in various forms, like whenever we go to a grocery shop or whenever you are going to purchase any product, we use this. And there are many live examples. I would like to give you one example. If I am going to a shop to buy some vegetables, like okay, I am going to buy 5 kg of potatoes and 3 kg beans and 1/2 kg lemon. Okay, now what is the total weight of my purchase? The total weight of my purchase, I can have it the same way. That will be 5 plus 3, 8 plus half, 8.5 kg. In case I have some exam, if I have some units and grams, I have to convert to the same unit. If I have 3500 grams and if I have 500 grams, either I will change the kgs all to kgs or all to grams, and then only I can add them. So I can add it as, I can change the 5000 kgs as 5 kgs as 5000 grams and then add it. So I am getting 9000 grams or 9 kg. So whenever you add, please convert it into the same unit and then add or subtract. Okay, in this topic we have learned the three main contents of measurements, that is length, mass and
perimeter and area for class 4. Okay, first, what is perimeter? Perimeter is the distance around the edge of a figure, or it is called the length of the boundary. So if I have a figure, I have a square. Now what is the perimeter of this square? This is the starting point. So the length which is covered by going one round around the figure is called the perimeter.
Example, if I have, this is 5 cm, this is 5 cm.
You know that in a square all sides are equal.
So 5 cm and 5 cm, the perimeter is equal to
sum of all the sides or the length of the boundary of the square.
So 5 plus 5 plus 5 plus 5
which is equal to 20 centimeters. Okay, if I have, this is a regular shape. If I have some other different irregular shapes, how will I find the perimeter of irregular shapes?
For example, I have a circle.
How will I find the perimeter of a circle? Now, or
a leaf.
Now,
I have to keep a string.
I'll take a string.
I have a starting point. From this point, I'll be keeping the string on the boundary of the circle. And when I come to the end point,
I'll take out the string and keep the string on the ruler and measure it. That will give me the length of the boundary. The perimeter of a circle is also called as the circumference of the circle.
The same thing I will do for the leaf. I'll start the string, I'll keep the string here, fixed here, and from here I will extend it and come back to the original position.
Then I will take out the string and measure it with the scale.
Now, if I have shapes like this, now I'm going to draw shapes.
Now, what is the perimeter of this shape?
Now, let us take one unit. One unit is equal to 1 centimeter.
So the length of each square or the side of each square of the grid is 1 centimeter.
Now this is 1 centimeter, 1 centimeter, 1, 1, 1. All this is 1 centimeter.
So the perimeter of this figure is
7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 12 centimeters.
Okay.
Let's take another example. If I have a pentagon and they have given the length of the sides, that is, this is 3 cm, this is 2 cm, 2 cm and 4 cm, and they've asked us to find the missing length by giving the perimeter of this figure. Perimeter is equal to 20 centimeter. Now find the length of the missing side. How will I find it? Now I should add all these sides and subtract it from 20. That is 3 plus 2, 5 plus 2, 7 plus 4, 11.
So 20 minus 11 is equal to 9. So the length of the missing side is 9 centimeters. Okay, now let's move on to area. Area. Now, area, what do you mean by area? Area is the surface covered by a figure.
Surface. Now, if I keep this duster on the board, it covers some area. That is called the area of the base of the duster. Now you can see that it is a rectangular shape. How do I measure the area of the different shapes? Now for this I need grids. I'm going to draw this same rectangle. So the outer is the perimeter and the inner space
is called the area.
Now I am divided the grids as 1 centimeter. Each grid is 1 centimeter by 1 centimeter. So what is the area? How many squares are present inside the rectangle? There are 2 squares. 1, 2. So the area of this rectangle is 2 square centimeters. Okay, let's take another one. Now, to find the area of this figure, you have to count the number of squares. Now, there are 1, 2, 3, 4 full squares and 2 half squares. So, the total area of this figure is 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 full squares and 2 half squares. So, 2 half is equal to 1 square. So, the total is 4 plus 1, 5 square centimeter. Okay, now let's see for irregular shapes. How to find the area of irregular shapes? Okay, before going to the shape, I shall give you some instructions. That is, if the square is fully covered, then it is considered as one full square. Okay, if it is shaded halfway, that is half a square, then in case we are taking 3/4 of the square, then it will be considered as one full square. If there is only a small part which comes within the area, it is neglected. Okay, now let me draw a figure. Now, let me show you how many full squares and half squares are there. So, this can be taken as one full square and these two can be taken as half a square. This also can be taken as half a square and this is 3/4, so it can be taken as a full square. So, totally the area of this leaf is 2 full squares plus half and half plus half. So, it is 3.5 square centimeters. So, in this lesson, we have learned how to find the perimeter of regular shapes, then irregular shapes, and also how to find the area of regular and irregular shapes.